In this video, we're going to compute the integral from 0 to 2 of sine pi x dx. And I want to do this integral actually in two different ways. First, we can handle it quickly by just exploiting the symmetries in the problem. And basically what we discover is that no calculations are even necessary. But I do want to follow that up by showing how you can solve this integral using what I would call brute force, because it is a good illustration of how to use the chain rule backwards. And the whole point about symmetries here is that if we integrate a sinusoidal function on an integer number of periods, we can expect that integral to vanish. And we'll just bring in a picture to illustrate why. So the point is that when you integrate a sinusoidal function on an integer number of periods, you're going to have positive contributions to the area exactly canceling negative contributions to the area, and the integral vanishes. Well, this sinusoidal function, sine pi x, happens to have a period of exactly 2. That's 2 pi divided by the coefficient of x. So when we look at a graph of it and we shade in the area corresponding to the integral, we get this perfect cancellation and the integral vanishes. So I would consider that by far the best way to solve this problem, because learning how to exploit symmetries is such a critical skill for applied mathematicians and physicists and engineers. But for completeness, I do want to take a look at the brute force approach to the problem. So there's our integral, and I want to do a little bit of setup to make it easier to use the chain rule backwards here. Now, the reason I'm thinking about that is because we have a function composition in this integrand, and pi x is the interior function. Well, if we could get the derivative of that tacked on to this integrand, in other words, pi, it's going to make it easier to see how the chain rule operates backward. So I can do that provided that I compensate out in front with a 1 over pi. That 1 over pi is a spectator, as we guess the antiderivative. Now the thing I differentiate to get pi sine pi x is going to be a negative cosine pi x. The minus sign is there because the derivative of cosine, if I go the other way around now, the derivative of cosine produces a minus sign. And then I can see by thinking about the derivative of this cosine pi x that the chain rule would produce the factor of pi that I put into the integrand. And this is really the key to getting good at doing the chain rule backwards. Sometimes you're kind of guessing as you work backwards, but if you always check by taking the derivative of your antiderivative and it works, it makes it easier and easier to see the chain rule backwards. Okay, so we're going to evaluate this thing from 0 to 2. And so I have a 1 over pi and then a negative cosine of 2 pi. And then we subtract the lower limit there, so we get a plus cosine of 0. Well, the cosine of 2 pi is 1. So this term becomes negative 1, cosine of 0 is 1. So I end up with negative 1 plus 1, and that gives me 0, the same result that we got by exploiting the symmetry of the problem. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.